Okay. Hi. Yeah, this is Bruce, or Alpha, and I'm going to talk to you about the pupil sound effect in mothers-in-law. Now, imagine some X-Wing flying around and shooting and the sound effects, so as a replacement of the video. And the reason is basically this screenshot. It made it to Twitter during development phase, and it inspired a lot of people about consequences for Nextcloud 14, like that the mother-in-law's a dependency, and someone came up with a business idea to have a mother-in-law as a service. But what I want to talk about, in fact, is how to get those nice bullet points indeed into your browser window. So that was also planned in our planning meeting for Nextcloud 14, and was just, well, a task, just put the three bullet points for everything that's, or some short description that's new in Nextcloud. So yeah, another problem. What does it take to put there just three items? And then you start thinking about where does it need to come from, how should it look like, and well, in reality, we start with implementing it, see some issues, but there's another priorities, and then you do the whole story again, because the interface ideas changed, etc. And in the end, we ended up with this scenario. Maybe it's not so beautiful, but I hope it explains how it works. So on the left, big block, that's the Nextcloud server, the yellow block. Ground should display the application layer, and then you have the app.notification. Notification. That's kind of the trigger for when Nextcloud checks for an update. So it happens either via a background job or when the admin goes to the settings page. And then it asks the cure, get me the latest changes about the next upcoming version if there's an update. And well, then the Nextcloud QR that reaches out first to the update server. The original idea was to hand out the information about what's new, also with this payload about the available next version and the download link, etc. But this is requested quite often, and especially if you have translations inside as well, there's going to be quite a big amount of data that needs to go through the network again and again. So now we just report back an URL to the changelog server. The next cloud server again reaches out to this one here, and there gets the bullet points. Not only those that you have seen, but also three additional ones with content targeted to administrators who see it in the admin pages for the server overview. Yes, this is cached and then present it back to the update notification, and you see it in the UI. So the admins now see, small what's new link, and if they click on it, then this information pops up, plus additional three items for administrators, so they know what they need to take or think about when they upgrade. Maybe some system requirements changes, like we require now only PHP 7.0 in 14. And any additional requests, we also check this more often, more regularly, but this is cached, and it also sends an e-tag, so not all the time the content needs to go down. This solution implementation brought us also some bycatch, so this popover menu that was also talked about in the very first part that also got some contributions out of this, is a bit more flexible. We have, for developers, an iLanguage iterator that can also be fetched by the localization service. And this allows you to iterate over languages that apply to a user. So it first would get, maybe there's a forced language set in the server, and then you have your own preferences, and gets back to the default language. And this allows us to check which translations are there and which fits best to the user who is looking at it. All the stuff is also available. So there was no information from the what's new endpoint. You can read it and dismiss it. And the visible component should be also usable. What about apps? We are not there yet because it's a little bit different. And there is an issue for this that you can follow the development. Thank you very much.